HarperCollins presents Rory Branagan Detective, The Great Diamond Heist, written and read by Andrew Clover.
I am Rory Branagan. I am actually a detective. It all started because, for the last 7 years, one big mystery has loomed over my life. Where is my dad? He disappeared when I was 3. No one ever told me where he went or why. But then Cat Callahan said, "You should become a detective and find out. And I, my friend, will be your accomplice." Cat is a wild, freckle-faced girl who moved in next door. She is amazing at solving crimes and getting us into really weird fights. That very day, we tracked down some poisoners who were using venom from a blue-ringed octopus. Cat whacked one with a frying pan. Bang! I also found a secret letter from Dad saying he was hiding in the place where he was once happiest. A few days later, we discovered someone was stealing dogs. They even took my good friend, the sausage dog detective, Wilkins Welkin. So Cat sneaked out. She burrowed her way into the baddie's lair, and together we released the hounds. Then my friend Mrs. Welkin, growling the words, "You dirty flip-flap," hit the main baddie with a slipper. Slap! We also learned that on the day he ran off, Dad had left me in a car. A week later, a huge sum of money was stolen from our school. Cat was being blamed by Stephen Maysmith, the big police detective. I had to find a thief to rescue her, which I did. It was a Komodo dragon, the largest lizard in the world, whose teeth are loaded with venom. He belongs to Michael Mulligan, the most powerful crime lord in the land. A week later, someone tried to kill a dinner lady in our school. Our friend Corner Boy got them in a headlock and then drove them headfirst into a tank of newts. Then we all escaped out of a third story window onto a trampoline. Boing, 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 boing. A month after that, we found out that many years ago, Dad had invented a festival of car stunts called Car Bonanza. He sold it to Michael Mulligan, who controlled the whole festival from a tower surrounded by bats. We caught another baddie. Oh, and Cat also pushed me out of a plane, which I was not happy about. But to be fair, I had a parachute and she did it to save me. She certainly keeps things interesting. Only yesterday, I was bitten by a deadly snake and nearly died. But I was saved by, who else, that fast-thinking genius Cat Callahan, who jabbed anti-venom into my arm. On the verge of death, I had a flashback and I saw Dad running off on the day he disappeared. I realised I remembered where he went. So, the very next day after school, I am lying on my bed, cuddling Wilkins Welkin, and I'm sleepily thinking, but why did Dad never come back? When I am pushed into action by Cat Callahan, who sticks a finger in my nose. "You have to tell me," she says, "where did your dad go?" I tell her, "Ballycove." And I open my eyes to see her giving me a very serious look. "How do you know this?" she asks. "Because when I was bitten by the snake," I say, "I had a vision of Dad running there. I also know that is where he was happiest." "Rory," says Cat, "most detectives investigate. They gather
evidence. They don't just sit around getting bitten by snakes. Well, you don't have to come if you don't want to. Oh, she says, I'll come with you. She gives me a long stare. But I'm warning you again, Rory. If you find your dad, you might bring bad guys to him. I eat bad guys for breakfast, I tell her, and I ferret out their eyeballs for fun. But I have to say she is right. We are about to find bad guys and big heights and monsters and the deadliest of deadly danger. But worse than that, I also get the biggest, most heart-stopping surprise of my life. It's something to do with Kat, and I've noticed every freckle on her face, but I've never noticed this. Should I have spotted it? Did I see evidence but refuse to accept it? It makes me feel as if my whole family have been perched on the edge of a big high cliff all this time and were about to fall to her certain death. I'll tell you the whole story. Chapter 1. Cowpat. We set off to Bally Cove right away. It's one of those times when you know you must tell your mum what you're doing, but you can't tell her the whole truth or she'll kill you. I find her with her head in the dishwasher. Mum, I say, what are you doing? Just fixing this dishwasher. You're always fixing it. Why don't you get a new one or get someone to fix it properly? Because I don't have the money, she says, and I don't have anyone to help fix things because your dad ran off. What would you do if I found him? I ask. Why? She growls. What are you up to? Oh, nothing, I say. I'm just taking Wilkins for a walk. And I try to drift from the room, all light and airy, like a dandelion on the breeze. But unfortunately, I bump right into my brother's armpit, which smells of mouldy trainers mixed with cowpat. I heard you discussing Bally Cove, he says. I wasn't. When Dad took us there, he says, remember how we always ate those veggie scotch eggs? Then he laughs. They stank. Not as much as you do, I tell him. Take that back, he says, grabbing my ear with his slimy fingers. Or I'll tell Mum you're pretending to be a detective again. I'm not pretending to be a detective, I say. I am one. So why haven't you worked out that freckle-faced girl is using you for something? That's what girls do. And I'm wanting to say, you're just saying that because Julia has dumped you. Probably because you stink. But I don't. Give me credit, I don't. I stay professional. I put on my hat and my new detective stealth sling and I just walk out the front door. And I see Corner Boy across the street. Rory, he shouts in his foghorn voice. I'm off to Granny Gilligan's with Mrs. Welkin.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.